This is WWF history in the making. An empty arena match for the first time ever. Rock and Mankind going at it for the WWF title. 10 falls will count anywhere in the arena. We have cameras in the locker rooms. We have cameras in the parking lots. We have cameras everywhere. They're out on a loading dock. The men will call a paralyzing maneuver and stop. Not gonna go. What's he gonna do now? He's gonna run over him. Oh, it's gonna crush the Rock. No, don't pin him. But no. Mankind becomes a WWF champion with the aid of a forklift.
Mankind, you beat The Rock, but if it weren't for a forklift, you would have never, never, ever beaten The Rock. You want a rematch, Rock? All you've got to do is ask. The Rock proposes a match called Last Man Standing. You want a Last Man Standing match with Mankind? You have got a deal.
China, because you know I'm a very fair and equitable human being. So therefore, I believe it would be unfair to see Triple H one-on-one with you. It wouldn't be fair at all. Because, let's face it, you would totally annihilate and humiliate Triple H like he has never, ever been humiliated before. Therefore, in the interest of fairness, I believe that Hunter Hearst Helmsley should have himself a tag team partner. And that tag team partner should be X-Pac.
My broadcast colleagues, good buddy.
So Triple H and X-Pac will square off against China, and China's tag team partner, Kane.
Wow. A tag team match made for next Sunday at St. Valentine's Day Massacre.
Now then, you want to talk about a massacre? There are going to be a number of them 1 week from tonight. on St. Valentine's Day. What a massacre it's going to be. The last man standing match. The Rock going one-on-one with Mankind for the WWF Championship. But let's think about how this match came about. How it came about is because, quite frankly, Mankind is nothing more than a thief. You see, at the Royal Rumble, The Rock annihilated Mankind. He could have finished him off there. And then Mankind steals $100,000 in cash from my son's trust fund that was a gift to The Rock. Holds it over his head, blackmails Rock, blackmailed him into a match. And had it not been for that stinking Mr. Sacco and a forklift, The Rock would still be the WWF champion as we speak. Nonetheless, I'm confident that 1 week from tonight, The Rock will once again regain his rightful place as the WWF champion. And indeed, Mankind, in all likelihood, you'll never wrestle again. As a matter of fact, I predict that you'll be massacred and butchered so badly by The Rock, you may not even ever walk again. And then that would bring us to Stone Cold Steve Austin. A lot of people think Austin showed restraint when he walked away from me. No, that wasn't restraint. But it was cold. It was stone cold fear.
I don't know about that.
Now, Austin, you may not necessarily be afraid of me, but you are afraid of defeat. You are afraid of history repeating itself, because it just eats you alive that me, Vince McMahon, took you and threw you over the top rope single-handedly and became the winner of the Royal Rumble. So Austin, you go ahead and put up that number one spot of contention at WrestleMania, because you know I have a plan. You know I have a foolproof plan. You don't know how. All you know is that Vince McMahon is going to defeat you 1 week from tonight. And indeed, Austin, your career will be massacred. Said and done. There you are, left inside that steel cage. Vince McMahon is on the outside. Who knows what a heaping mass of jelly you're going to turn into. Once again, Vince McMahon defeats Stone Cold. But just to make sure you're ready for the match, Austin, tell you what I'm going to do. You and Mankind deserve each other. No doubt about that. So therefore, why shouldn't we book a little warm-up match on Saturday night, this coming Saturday night, the night before St. Valentine's Day, one-on-one, non-title, Mankind versus Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Another huge announcement from Mr. McMahon.
Good luck, Austin. Good luck, Mankind. And by the way, to both Mankind as well as Stone Cold, from the bottom of my heart, happy Valentine's Day.
No chance, that's what you got.
I thank you very much.
And not a hint of sarcasm in his voice either. A heartfelt greeting from Mr. McMahon for Stone Cold and Mankind. The order for them to meet each other the night before the St. Valentine's Day Massacre. They could massacre each other on Raw Saturday night. Well, it's apparent that Mr. McMahon has designs on impacting not only the Valentine's Day Massacre next Sunday, but potentially also WrestleMania by ordering Stone Cold Steve Austin and Mankind to meet on Raw Saturday night.
Beautiful, beautiful.
What a blockbuster announcement to kick off the hour.
What do you expect from Pretty Mac? What do you expect?
Well, proactive as always. But here tonight on Heat, Shane, we're also going to see a triple threat elimination tag team match with the tag team champions and Debra in the eye of a storm.
You know who else is going to be doing that, Kev? You know who's going to be in that match? Triple H and X-Pac, my buddy. But don't worry. Maybe there's a little plan for X-Pac. Who knows what's going on?
That wouldn't surprise me. Plus, also, who's the number one contender for the WWF Women's title? We're going to find out when Luna takes on Jacqueline. Shane, I wonder what Sable thinks about that. Back, everyone, to Sunday Night Heat. Tag team action coming up featuring the Oddities. And it's good to see George the Animal Steele back out with his crew. The original Oddity, Shane.
Yeah, check out George's bluegrass. Look at that freak show.
Of course, George the Animal Steele victimized by Draws a couple of weeks ago. And then last week, it was Kurrgan. I don't know what Draws' problem is as of late, but, I mean, his actions beneath contempt.
What do you mean? Draws is doing what he has to do to make a name for himself.
Draws is a punk. He's a punk.
Ooh, come on. Careful, Ken. Careful, Ken. Draws is a little unstable. You got to give props to Draws. He's the man, takes things into his own hands, and gets the jobs done.
Introducing, at a combined weight of 429 pounds, Team Sexy Brian Christopher, Scott, Two Hot Taylor, Two Bunch.
Been a real love fest since Scott Taylor came back off the injured list.
I dig the outfits, though. Check them out. Very colorful. It's like kaleidoscope. Remember that thing you used to look at when you were a kid? All those brilliant colors.
Back in the 70s, you mean?
Back in the 70s. Speaking of the 70s, tonight, right after Heat, you know who's up? Wait till you see The Rock wearing this bro. Oh, it is unbelievable. Tune in to Fox, That 70s Show, and wait till you see Shamrock's little do action going on.
Can we call
The Rock playing his dad, Rocky Johnson.
Can we call him Ken Shagrock?
Shagrock?
WWF St. Valentine's Day Massacre in your house is presented by Western Union Money Transfer. Live next Sunday on pay-per-view.
Hey, there's
Western Union, the fastest way to send money worldwide.
Yo, there's your boy. There's your boy, Kev. Why don't you stand up and say a little something out of Draws?
He's got a piece of hickory in his hand. That's no surprise. Mocking.
Whoa, check out the agility on Giant Silva.
Looks as if he's asking Silva to follow in the back.
That's it.
Boy, yeah, go ahead and mess with Silva. Go ahead. Good move, Draws.
Wait, I wouldn't mess with Draws. Check out Draws has got strategy. You got to give props to Draws. He's making a name for himself. Watch your head, Silva. Whoa, watch that.
What the heck is he doing?
Boy, Silva is as dumb as he looks.
So Kurrgan starts off here against Too Sexy. Obvious size disparage between the tag team champions of the universe.
Obvious size.
And yeah, too much.
Obvious. Kurrgan is a little bit bigger, isn't he?
Fire across. Misses with the clothesline. And nice slide through good agility.
There it is. Beautiful. Come on. Let's go, Brian Christopher.
How about Kurrgan? I understand he's really playing the market now.
Yeah, Kurrgan. Oh, Mankind. Let's get back to Mankind right now. Mankind is spending The Rock's money, which used to be my money. It's The Rock's reward. Well, all I got to say is Mankind is going to be paying 1 week from tonight. Last man standing. St. Valentine's Day Massacre. Rock will be the last man standing in the new WWF champion.
Perhaps it'll be the most brutal chapter in their trilogy. But first, Mankind is going to have to face the challenge of Stone Cold Steve Austin. Look at Kurrgan launched Scott Taylor 3/4 of the way across the ring. Wait a minute.
Oh, Josh, baby.
What a coward.
What do you mean, what a coward? Good move. Oh, the bigger they are, the harder they fall.
Why is he on this campaign of brutalizing the Oddities?
Because that's what Draws is all about. It doesn't matter if it's the Oddities or not. Get in here. Look at this. Yeah. That's intelligent.
Golga is not exactly the stereotypical scientific wrestler.
Hey, what were you saying before?
But Raw Saturday Night. Well, we know that on Raw Saturday Night, your father has made a match between... Oh, wait a minute. Now, why is DOA down here?
Ooh.
Obviously, Mankind and Stone Cold. Mr. McMahon wants to see these two destroy each other.
Well, of course.
course, Mr. McMahon will be there to pick up the pieces the following night in the steel cage.
You've got to give props to Pops one more time. It's a fair competitive match.
Wait a Mankind. Oh, watch it all. DOA. This is craziness out here. Now DOA is interfered on behalf of Too Much.
What's going on?
Referee didn't see it. The three count is told.
Nice.
Here are your winners, Too Much.
And is there some kind of relationship developing between Too Much and the DOA?
Well, actually, yeah, I have some thoughts on that matter. Did you see Police Academy 1?
Yeah.
Blue Oyster Bar scene?
Oh, come on now.
Nah.
I don't know about that, but certainly Too Much is thrilled with the fact that they gained the victory. But what about Droz? Droz attacking a giant Silva in the back. Wait a minute, what's this?
Ooh, Shawing! The corporate bait!
Why is she lacing her boots?
The Hardcore Championship on the line.
This is for the Hardcore Championship. No holds barred. Broke Dog, Broke Dart, the Hardcore Champion. No holds barred.
Al Snow.
Al Snow would love to become the Hardcore Champion.
Hardcore, baby! Hardcore!
Oh!
Chair to the head.
Al Snow up on the barricade.
Oh!
And Al Snow looks like he loves it. Look at him.
No rules in this one. No holds barred.
Gals! Oh!
I consider myself the crown prince of hardcore.
Al Snow, look at him, he's smiling, he loves it.
Together with you, you saw that, didn't you?
Hardcore tag team match. Al Snow teaming with the Road Dog.
Now you own me, so you give me the best 2 out of 3 for that hardcore title.
Road Dog and Al Snow, they formed a bond in recent weeks.
See, that belt says that I'm the champ.
Hardcore champion of the world.
My friend, you have got it.
Road Dogg and Al Snow will go at it at the St. Valentine's Day Massacre.
Well, I'm telling you, this one is not going to be for the weak at heart either.
Al Snow, Road Dogg is the hardcore champion. We've seen him do all kinds of things, through tables, chair shots, anything imaginable. What are you going to do to prove that you're truly hardcore?
What am I going to do? What am I going to do? What are we going to do? I don't know. I don't know. I might break the broom over his head. I might stick him in a trash can. Let's see. There's so many things that I can have fun with. I can have fun with a chair. And maybe just blind him. Boy, that stuff's cool. If that doesn't work, if he's still coming, I might find a table and put him through it. If he doesn't break the first time, you know what they say? Try again. Oh, God. It doesn't matter what I do, though, to him. The one thing I will do, though, is I will take that belt and I will make him pay for turning on me. Road Dogg, you wanted to play the game? You want to try and be hardcore? You think you're hardcore? I don't think so!
Al Snow is off his rocker. He has lost it. Al Snow is obsessed with the hardcore title.
Wait a minute now, Shane. We're live. Is that Ryan Shamrock with Val Venus?
Oh, no. I got to tell Kenny. Somebody tell Kenny. Shamrock's up next. Oh, raise that roof, baby. It's time to get aboard the... Check out that talent.
It's scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, Bruce
120 pounds, the Godfather.
For a man that says pimping ain't easy, how come he's always smiling?
I'd be smiling too. Check that out. Hello, hello, hello.
Well, I tell you, Godfather might have that smile quickly removed from his face, though, because he's getting set to take on the Intercontinental Champion, Ken Shamrock.
This is true, and Shamrock is hot because I told him what was going on just before the commercial break with Val Venus. Shamrock went crazy. He went absolutely ballistic, tore the locker room apart, you know, and he can't do anything to his sister. He's a rock in a hard place, but Val is a different story.
Tonight, folks, Sunday Night Heat is brought to you by Twix Cookie Bar. Twix, two for me, none for you.
And by Idaho's Interactive, makers of Tomb Raider 3.
And by Castrol. Stop by any participating Pep Boys stores to get a free 6-foot Stone Cold Steve Austin poster when you buy a case of Castrol Motor Oil, the official motor oil of the WWF. Offer good while supplies last. And wait till you see the Stone Cold Steve Austin driven by Jerry Tolliver. More on that in the weeks to come.
It's time once again for everybody to come aboard the whole train.
How many times has your ticket been punched, Shane?
Woo-hoo! Right. Hey, easy now.
From the very top of this building, right down to the front row, if you like what you're looking at,
we likes.
Let me hear you say, pimpin' ain't easy. Pimpin' ain't easy.
Actually, it would be quite easy with that bunch of talent right there. Uh-oh, but check it out. The fun is over.
Good from Mesa, California. Weighing 235 pounds, the World Wrestling Federation Intercontinental Champion, Ken Shamrock.
And Shamrock is furious. His little sister in the back making out with Val Venus. Shamrock defends the Intercontinental title next Sunday against Val.
Absolutely. Well, you saw right in the back, and Ken is taking a little of aggression. What would you do, Kevin, if that was your little sister?
I think I would be
a little bit payback.
Well, I understand that, but if I were you, I think I'd mind my own business.
Oh, absolutely not. That's what you got to do with Ken. Get him fired up. He's an animal. No one can take Shamrock.
Oh,
forget about.
Well, the question everybody's been asking is, why would Ryan Shamrock go against her brother's wishes and date Val? I mean, obviously, if Ryan is trying to rebel here against a very overbearing, over-controlling big brother.
I know nothing about that. Oh, watch it! Come on, Ken, watch it! Oh, drills it right in the back of his shoulder. Godfather caught Kenny right in the shoulder. Ooh, that was down across the throat. Godfather's a huge man. Come on, Ken, you can't take that punishment.
And of course, folks, Ken Shamrock, in just about an hour from now, is going to be donning a shag, going back in time to the 70s on That 70s Show, Shane.
I can't wait to see, as you said earlier, Shamrock. Uh-oh, watch out, Godfather going with the train. Come on, Ken, fire up. Shamrock's obviously distracted. He's got Ryan in the back. You know, I mean, how hard is that for a man? How hard is that for a big brother to sit there knowing your sister's in the back, purposely defying you? Come on, Ken, get up, baby. Watch it. Elevation. That's it. Beautiful.
Wow.
Nice move, Ken. Nice move.
The knees into the midsection of the Godfather. Momentum has swung. And, of course, Val Venus, folks, with an opportunity to take the Intercontinental title away from Ken Shamrock. He's taking his little sister. Will the Intercontinental title be next?
Never.
Power slam. No, sir, it is not over, but certainly Val Venus has gotten Ken Shamrock so far off of his game, Shane, even you would have to say that Shamrock will be the underdog next Sunday at St. Valentine's Day.
Look at that, man. Are you crazy? Are you out of your...
Hello, Kenny. You know something, Kenny? I realize the importance of staying in control while you're in the zone. Right now, I'm in the zone. about to lose control. Oh, my God.
Oh, no. Boy. Shamrock's going to freak out.
His head is going to explode.
Shamrock's going to freak out.
Oh, he's freaking out. Shamrock's freaking out. Phallus toast. Venus is toast. There definitely is going to be no Venus envy there. Val is going down hard.
We're
going
to see if we can get a camera in the back. Obviously, the emotions are running very high between Val Venus and Ken Shamrock. And I'm sure emotions will be running high 6 days from now. Raw Saturday night, 8 Eastern, 7 Central. Stone Cold one-on-one against Mankind.
Oh, beautiful. My pops, give props to the pops one more time for making that match the night before St. Valentine's Day Massacre, Raw Saturday night.
Our cameras have caught up with Val and one question. Val, wait a minute.
Come on, Ken, that's it. Payback time. I would not want to beat Val Venus. No, thank you. Oh! Oh! Oh!
She loves him.
Oh, wrong words. That is the worst three words you can hear. Beat a big brother. I love him. Ew. Val Venus, you're not done paying yet. I can guarantee that, big boy.
Watch this. Well, Shane, we are moments away from finding out who will be the next one to challenge Sable in WWF Women's Championship.
Yeah, look, Sable always wants the spotlight. Coming out to get a little face time, a little on-camera time.
And we understand, folks, that Val Venus is now receiving medical attention. Man, oh man, what an attack by Shamrock.
Oh, yes, and I guarantee Shamrock is not finished with Val yet. Val had a great strategy trying to psych out Shamrock, but it didn't work. Kevin, what's this all about?
I figured we could have some expert analysis for the WWF Women's Champion.
Yeah, we figured wrong. Yeah, what am I going to do about it now? Let's look away.
I apologize. Sable, thank you very much for joining us here on Sunday Night Heat. Looking as lovely as always. We're happy to have you with us.
Happy to be here.
And Sable, I know it's a big contest coming up. Jacqueline and Luna, the winner will be the number one contender for your Women's Championship.
Right, and both of them are very tough competitors.
Chum, expert analysis by the WWF Women's Champion, not.
Well, here comes Jacqueline, who along with Terry Runnels had been manipulating D'Lo Brown as of late. But D'Lo found out the truth, that Terry had been lying to him all along. Dr. Francois Petit told D'Lo there was no baby. She was never pregnant, and D'Lo's days of being manipulated are apparently over.
Boy, I guess we should be graced here by having Sable next to us.
Hello, Shane.
Oh, hello, Sable. How you doing?
I'm doing fine.
Sable, you know, you're so much of a prima donna, you just need to know where your role is. You know, what place you're supposed to be put in, and that's put right back in place. Right here, you know where you're supposed to be. You're nothing but a showpiece.
I know exactly where my role is. Oh, yeah. I was invited here this evening, and I'm going to enjoy my visit with Mr.
Kelly. We'll go over that later, by the way.
All right.
Okay, Kev.
Yeah. Well, Jacqueline's been introduced. Here comes her opponent. This is going to be a rugged matchup.
Here comes the lovely Luna.
Luna!
You know, both of these women are extremely competitive and tough. I would have to say that Luna is the thing nightmares are made out of. I think Jacqueline is a little more technical wrestler, but both of them are extremely tough competitors.
Boy, and nobody knows that better than you. You've been in with both of them, and you will at one point have the phone of the winner of this contest.
What's up, Luna, baby? How you doing? Yeah, woman. Look at that. Exactly. And go on, watch your back, watch your back.
Well, you can see the competitive nature in both coming out right away as Jacqueline attacking Luna before the bell.
You know, I'm very surprised to see that Luna would have allowed Jacqueline to do that to her. The veteran that she is, she should know better than to turn her back on someone.
Seemed to be a little distracted by you at ringside.
What are you kidding? Just stick to what you do best, Sable, and that's, again, be a showpiece. I mean, you know, hey, you have to call
Thank
my...
Thank you for noticing,
yeah,
Shane.
Yeah. Well, everyone notices. That's exactly what your role is. You know, you have to call my pops. He said, boy, you've done a great job building up that Sable lady. You know, can I put her in a magazine? Yeah, so bang, you're going to be in Playboy.
Well, let me just say, I'm glad
tonight.
You know a lady when you see one.
A lady when you see one. Sable, you'd be nothing without my pops. You know that, don't you?
You know, the only thing I owe your father is a big thank you.
Yeah, right, you do. Yeah,
he has definitely given me an opportunity, and with that opportunity, I have succeeded. You know, you have to have talent.
That opportunity. So you say it's your hard work that's done that, huh, Sable?
It is definitely my hard work that's got me where I am today. forced to admit to the fact that I have a mind.
Oh, am I having
a mind? If we could just talk about the action here.
You talk about it. You got me all fired up.
Wait a minute.
Sable out here. Prima Donna once again. That's a good idea. Let's call the match. And, I wish I was Sable's neck getting crunched by Luna. Yeah, that is
cool. Come on, Shane.
Check out Luna. Going up top. Oh! Luna, devastating.
Two.
Come on, Luna. Now, Luna's hot. Talk about a physical specimen. Check out Luna.
High level of intensity by both Jacqueline and Luna. Luna on the offense right now, a full slam, and I think she's going to go to the top rope this time.
Going tippy-top. Jacqueline's a nice little package also, though.
Sable, I got to wonder, who would you rather face? Would you rather take on Luna or Jacqueline?
Unfortunately, I cannot choose who I defend my title against, but I would definitely say that...
Wait a minute. Why is D'Lo Brown coming down to ringside?
D'Lo in the house.
Wow, D'Lo put the bad mouth on Jacqueline. This is giving Luna an opportunity to recover.
Very unexpected.
Come on, Luna!
DDT!
Mercy!
Hook at the leg. Two, and we got a winner.
Well, I guess I know who my next competitor will be.
I say, well, I can't wait until Luna DDTs you just like that. One, two, three, it's over.
And as always, Shane, it's been my pleasure.
Oh, it's been my pleasure, Sable. No.
Well, Sable, I want to thank you for joining us. Luna victorious, and obviously D'Lo Brown now on the offensive going after PMS.
Ooh! Yo, baby!
What's on her mind?
I don't know, but it's going to be dangerous.
It's a day for giving.
I'm going to get me some.
A day for sharing.
Austin 316 says I just ripped your...
A time to tell that special someone how you really feel.
I hate Austin!
Vince McMahon, I know you hate my guts, and I feel the same way about you.
Austin McMahon, a steel cage. WWF St. Valentine's Day Massacre, live on pay-per-view.
So is Debra next on Sexual Chocolate's list? Welcome back, everyone, to Sunday Night Heat. Did you see that, Mark Henry? Sexual Chocolate, baby. Oh, and there's the liberated D'Lo Brown. You better recognize, Kev.
I know it's going to be good.
Getting ready for a triple threat tag team matchup. Mark Henry, D'Lo Brown taking on... From D-Generation X, Triple H, and of course, my buddy, X-Pac.
And don't forget, the tag team champions are in this as well. Owen Hart and Jeff Jarrett with the lovely Debra by their side.
Oh, yeah. Free the puppies. Let him run. The pokey little puppy.
I hope that book. I hope that you're not going to be trying to start something with X-Pac.
No. Not me. You know me better than that, Kevin.
Yeah, that's the trouble. I do know you.
What are you talking about?
Well, I know how you are.
What you talking about, Kev?
You let that temper run wild with you sometimes.
The following contest is a triple threat tag team elimination match.
Yeah, baby, be quiet, Howard.
About to come down, accompanied by Debra, at a combined weight of 467 pounds. The World Wrestling Federation.
Jeff and Owen perfectly suited for one another, but it appears that Debra is the adhesive that has brought this team to the top.
Adhesive. Debra should come out to that song by ZZ Top. She's got legs. How apropos would that song be? Damn. I got to give credit when credit is due, and credit is due to Jeff Jarrett and Owen Hart. They are the WWF Tag Team Champions. What an accomplishment that is, especially by beating Shamrock and Bossman from the corporation.
And Debra, of course, the constant manipulator, taking advantage of Sexual Chocolate last Monday on Raw.
Break it down.
Representing D-Generation X at a combined weight of 448 pounds, X-Pac and Triple H, Hunter Hurst Helmsley.
You give credit where credit is due. How about giving some credit to both Triple H and X-Pac?
Well, you got to give credit to both of these guys. Unfortunately, I have to give a little credit to X-Pac because he is the most resilient guy I have ever seen in my life. He's like Gumby. He just bends. He never breaks, and he's always got the energy. Triple H, what can you say? He hits you with the pedigree. It's all over no matter who you are.
Well, certainly you have done a lot of
location when it comes to X-Pac as of late. X-Pac, the European champion, Triple H, within an eyelash of becoming the WWF champion. And both men would love to become tag team champions.
Watch this, Ken, watch this. Going down, X-Pac. Yeah, you. Hey, X-Pac, you're going down, man. You're going down, punk. You're going down. Jimmy, you're going down.
He's looking right at you.
Yeah, yo, bring it up. Oh, yeah, really? Come on, why don't you come get some? You get your day, X-Pac. You're going to get your day, and you're going to pay. X-Pac, you're going to get your day. Maybe one day soon, but definitely 1 week from tonight, St. Valentine's Day Massacre against my big buddy Kane. And, of course, the lovely China.
It'll be Kane and China taking on Triple H and X-Pac, a match made by your father, the beginning of this broadcast. Not only that, but also ordering Stone Cold Steve Austin to take on Mankind this Saturday on Raw Saturday night, the night before St. Valentine's Day Massacre.
Special edition. Look, Owen's going for the hair. Typical cheap move there. Of course, there is no hair on D'Lo. D'Lo, that, oh, yeah. Oh, you better recognize.
You better recognize the action's going to continue to sizzle here tonight on USA. Next, Granger goes Greek to take down a killer frat house. Ride with the pack on Pacific Blue.
And at 9, it's a Cinderella story with murder at midnight. The crimes of passion continue to heat up Palm Beach on silk stockings.
And at 10, you picked him. Now we've got him. It's La Femme Nikita's most wanted episode. And tonight, Michael's new love may put an end to Section 1. Peter Wilson stars as La Femme Nikita. Stay where you are. Sunday Night Heat continues right here on USA.
Come on, D'Lo. Grind that head. Grind it.
Big shoulder block. They say the truth will set you free. Revealing that Terry Rollins was never pregnant, obviously has lifted a tremendous burden from D'Lo Brown's shoulders.
Come on, D'Lo. Come on, D'Lo.
Tag made. Jeff Jarrett is in. Great teamwork, though, for the tag team champions.
Yeah, teamwork is what it's all about. Hence, tag team action. Let's talk about my pops, Vinnie Mac, for a second.
One of your favorite subjects.
Of course he's my favorite subject. Vinnie Mac is going to take Austin out. Oh, just like that. Vinnie Mac will scoop Austin just like D'Lo did. Slam his ass to the canvas.
You told me last week your father's strategy was vertical.
It doesn't matter. My pops has got the mad hops. True, he can go out through the door over the top of the cage. But Vinnie Mac told me he wants to punish Austin because everyone knows Austin is afraid of my pops. He is afraid of losing, and that's exactly what's going to happen to Stone Cold 1 week from tonight, the St. Valentine's Day Massacre.
If Mr. McMahon defeats Stone Cold Steve Austin inside that cage.
When
he does. If he does, 1 week. Then Stone Cold Steve Austin will not be the number one contender. Mr. McMahon will assume all rights and privileges as that number one contender, and Austin's shot at WrestleMania is gone.
History, sayonara, see you later, and then Vinnie Mac will name the number one contender. I wonder who that might be. Who knows? It's up to the genius, Wile E. Coyote genius.
Well, in the spirit of a
come
triple
on,
threat tag.
Hold on. Come on, D'Lo. Come get you some.
You can tag any member. You can tag any member of any team at any time. And that's the reason that D'Lo Brown and X-Pac now find themselves at each other.
Come on, D'Lo. Come on, D'Lo. Oh, yeah. Lovely. Love it. Love it. Come on, D'Lo. One more time. Nail X-Pac. Oh,
wait. Well, that pace quickens. And X-Pac becomes so dangerous.
Whoa. Come on, D'Lo.
Oh, no.
Ouch.
It amazes me, Shane, how you have just absolutely just tried to aggravate an athlete like X-Pac.
Oh, yeah.
Skyline.
Oh, baby.
This one is over.
Oh, give D'Lo a bonus. Loving that. Good move, D'Lo.
Watch D'Lo. It.
Oh, D'Lo got plastered.
Jarrett just conked D'Lo.
No.
One, two. And D'Lo and Mark Henry have been eliminated.
Come on. All right. Come on, Jeff. Come on. Owen, get in there. That's it. Beautiful. Get on that.
And now Triple H and X-Pac, who will take on Kane and China next Sunday at the St. Valentine's Day Massacre, are letting the tag team champions have it.
Come on, Owen. Come on, Owen.
Double team now on Owen Hart.
Come on, Owen. Oh, no.
The five-time tag team champion is in a whole lot of trouble. D-Generation X is in control.
Oh!
High knee.
Not looking good for Owen at the moment.
The tag team champions are on the road. Wait a minute. China. China coming down to the ring.
Valentine's Day Massacre, and all hell is going to break loose. The World Wrestling Federation presents a two-hour action-packed, bone-crushing primetime special. WWF Raw, Saturday night, this Saturday at 8 p.m., 7 Central on USA.
Can't wait for Raw Saturday night.
Oh!
Raw preempted tomorrow night because of the West Windsor Dog Show here on USA.
Come on, Owen.
As Owen Hart now flies out over the top rope, the tag team champions have been on the receiving end. But China, the ninth wonder of the world, is down here at ringside as well.
Yeah, baby.
And obviously...
Let's talk about Raw Saturday night, a little special. You know what? I'm going to ask my pops to make a special match. Yeah, China, to make a special match. Maybe we'll have a little prelude to the St. Valentine's Day Massacre.
We already got that.
Maybe my buddy X-Pac will take on Kane.
What?
One-on-one. Yeah. I think my pops will grant me that. I like that match. Nice move, Jeff. Get on, X-Pac, get on.
Some more teamwork shown by the tag team champions. You mean to tell me that X-Pac is going to have to take on Kane one-on-one?
Yeah, I like that. I like those odds. Come on, baby. Here we go, Jeff. Raw Saturday night. Check it out.
Yeah, also Stone Cold Steve Austin against Mankind.
Oh, no.
Raw Saturday night, next Saturday, 8 Eastern, 7 Central on USA.
What a special. Here we go. Who knows what else my pops is going to think of. I love this. I love being on the flight. Oh, no.
You love this? Buster.
I panned you that maneuver. Come on, Owen. Get X-Pac. Come on, Owen.
Oh, Jeff into the stairs.
Woo-hoo! Nobody home for X-Pac.
And let's see if the tag team champions can capitalize now. Owen and X-Pac are the legal men in this triple threat tag team match.
Come on, Owen. Nice, Owen. Nice.
Capitalizing.
Oh, man, I've never been such an Owen fan.
Lateral press, didn't hook the leg, only gets a two, but you can see the effects on X-Pac as the ninth wonder of the world. Corporate China looks on from ringside.
Love the sound of that. Corporate China. China, the China syndrome.
Debra on our left collecting the pieces of Jeff Jarrett.
Oh, sharpshooter time. It's all over. Turn him over, Owen. Perfect.
Oh, wait a minute now. Triple H is in.
Dropkick!
And China, her eyes like laser beams shooting through Triple H.
Yeah, the China syndrome.
China and Triple H will meet in a tag team match on opposite teams next Sunday, St. Valentine's Day Massacre. The tag is made.
Come on, Owen.
And Triple H is finally in, cleaning house.
Come on, Jeff. Come on, Owen. Come on, anybody.
The defection of China has really wounded Triple H, affected the entire psyche of DX.
Oh, man. Triple H, gotta say, he's in fuego right now.
He certainly is.
Hey, come on, get that guy off.
The World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Owen Hart and Jeff.
Will it be a massacre before the massacre? In 6 days, a special Raw Saturday night. Stone Cold against Mankind. We'll see you there.